Joe won't just win the White House, though. He, with him at the top of the ticket, he's going to help us take over the Texas House of Representatives. When we do that, we can assure ourselves that we will no longer be talking about walls at the border. We will no longer be talking about bathroom bills. We will no longer be talking about stupid ideological partisan things that separate us. We're going to be working for a greater America, one that takes care of each and one of us, all of our families. But Joe needs our help. He needs each and one of us, our family, our friends, everyone. Are you with me? Then please stop and make sure you volunteer. And friends, I'm proud to introduce to you my friend and the next president of the United States, Joe Biden! By the way, well, thank you. I am Joe Biden's husband, and I'm delighted to be here. I want to start off by acknowledging I love executive vice presidents. Linda, you've done a great deal for the working men and women, and I just want you to know, I know how to pronounce the word union. Union. And, Senator, Jose, you're my kind of guy. I was telling the senator a little bit earlier. He reminds me of my son, who was the attorney general of the state of Delaware and a decorated Army veteran who spent a year in Iraq and a lot of time in Bosnia. But my son started an effort and organized, I think it's fair to say, nationally, efforts to see to it that we started to look out for abused children. And the work that you've done on cyberbullying, the work you've done to take care, not really me, Senator, it's been a big deal. It's been a big, big deal. It's one of the reasons why I've admired you from the beginning. So thank you for all you've done. And thank you. And Congress Vella is here as well. He was foolish enough to endorse me. I don't know where he is. Oh. Sir, reporting as ordered, sir. Thank you. One of the great leaders in our Congress, for real. Look, folks, I want to thank you all for coming today. It's great to be back in Texas. You're going to see a whole lot of me between now and next November, God willing. Because if I have the honor of winning this nomination, I'm going to compete here in Texas to win Texas. To win Texas. Look, we all know. We all know the challenges ahead of us are fundamentally different than anything we've faced before. No matter how young or old you are, your first vote, or this is you've been voting a long time. Literally, the core values that make us who we are, our standing in the world, our very democracy, is at risk under this administration. And few cities in America understand what it takes to secure those values. In San Antonio, Military City, USA. My wife, Jill, and I came down here many, many times to go to Brooke Army Medical Center to deal with our wounded warriors. I carry with me in my pocket every day my schedule. And every single day, the staff checks for the last 12 years. There's a black box I have here. And it lists the daily troop update, exactly, not generally, exactly how many fallen angels have fallen in Afghanistan and Iraq. Yesterday, it was 6,900. Today, it's 6,901. Every single one, those fallen angels was left behind the community. Everyone deserves to be remembered. It's not about generalities. It's about individuals. We have wounded in Iraq and Afghanistan. As of today, 52,962, not over 52,000, 962, because every one of them we owe a debt of gratitude to. Ladies and gentlemen, that's not even counting, Mr. Congressman knows, 300,000 have come home with post-traumatic stress. We have an obligation as long as they live, to care for them. I met some Vietnam veterans up top. Thank you for your service. But what's happened is, every single veteran that was wounded in Vietnam and passed away, 6 out of 10 of those same wounds are living because of the golden hour, we call it. But here's what it means. It means we have about a $9 billion commitment because they're going to live on average 35 years. I believe we only have one sacred obligation. We have many, but one sacred obligation. And I've been criticized for saying this for the past 35 years, and that's to prepare those and equip them, men and women we send to war, to defend our nation. Care for them and their families while they're gone, and care for them and their families when they come home. Our veterans deserve timely, world-class health care and comprehensive mental support, health support. They deserve a serious approach to ending veterans' homelessness. And they deserve a leg up when it comes to educational opportunities and economic opportunities. Most of all, they deserve leaders like the Congressman, the Senator, and others, leaders who fight for them as forcefully and as honorably as they have fought for us. And folks, I never thought I'd say this. I've served with 8 presidents. Donald Trump can't comprehend that level of service and sacrifice of our veterans. No, I'm not joking. At what their families have given for us. When my son was in Iraq for a year, my wife is a teacher, and every morning we get up and I'd walk into this large, we lived in a big old house, a large bathroom, and she'd be standing there drinking her coffee after having set her hair and mouthing a prayer every single solitary morning. And those of you who in fact have had spouses, children, parents who have served in combat, you know you dread the concern every single day. You think about it 10 times a day. There's a famous expression by an English poet. He said, "They also serve who only stand and wait." So thank all of you spouses, parents, for what you've done as well to preserve the veterans. You know, America can overcome 4 years of Donald Trump's chaos and corruption. But if elected, re-elected, if forever and fundamentally change the character of who we are as a nation, we can't let this happen. This election is about the soul of our nation. And Donald Trump has poisoned our soul. He fans the flames of hate, hate groups, white supremacists here at home. Coming down the escalator when he announced in Trump Towers, he said he was doing it before he hit the ground floor. Remember what he said? He said, "I'm going to take on those rapist Mexicans." Then he claimed, no, there's never been a president. Never been a president. Oh, it is a lie. You recall, he very well man represents... Just one second. This man represents Donald Trump very well. He's just like Donald Trump. So, folks, look. Claiming there's an invasion of America. Thank you. Thank you. The great American. The great American. All right, here we go. But here's the deal. Let him go. Just let him go. This is not a Trump rally. This is a real rally. As my mother would say, God bless me. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. All right. We all stand a long time. But here's the deal. Remember in 18 he claimed to try to save the skin of the party. He claimed there was an invasion of Latinos coming across the border, going to invade and pollute America. Well, guess what? Guess what? It's not the words presidents say matter. It wasn't too long after that, a guy down in El Paso walks into a parking lot and guns down a lot of innocent people, and he says, I'm doing it to prevent the invasion of Texas by Hispanics. Folks, Donald Trump isn't just dead wrong. He doesn't know who we are as a country. We're a nation of immigrants. People who came here from every country on earth. An endless source of courage and optimism. Look what Trump is doing to us. He's waged an unrelenting assault on our values and our history. And what he's doing is shaming the nation. You know? When a father and a baby daughter seeking the shores drowns, when children are locked away in cages, overcrowded detention centers, the government tries to keep them indefinitely, when Trump uses family separation as a weapon against desperate mothers, fathers, the children who seek safety and a better life, when he threatens massive raids to break up families, many who've been here for years and years, targets people at hospitals and schools, when children die in custody due to the lack of adequate care, it's morally wrong. It's un-American. And I promise you, it will stop when I am President of the United States. As president, I'll reverse the damage this man has done. I'll restore the progress Trump has cruelly undone by taking a different look at how we do this. I just released a comprehensive plan on immigration. I will not bore you with, I don't hope it wouldn't bore you, but I will not spend the time. It would take a long time. But look, we have to create a comprehensive plan to create a fair and just immigration system that enhances our economy, safeguards our security, reflects the American character, the highest values of our nation. In my first 100 days, I'll reverse Trump's cruel and counterproductive policy to separate families and children. Period. I will restore our historic commitment as a nation that welcomes asylum seekers and refugees. Welcome. That's who we've been. I'll surge humanitarian resources at the border. Support migrants waiting for their asylum claims to be assessed, and support organizations that help provide for their needs while they're waiting. We'll end for-profit detention centers. We'll channel the border security. Make smart investments that actually work, not build a wall that wastes millions of taxpayers' dollars. Look, I'll end prolonged detention. I'll invest in a management program, enable migrants to live with dignity and safety while they await their hearing. So they can go to a doctor if they need it, enroll their kids in school if need be. I'll protect dreamers and their families. They are here. And making sure. I love the way he talks about it. I can imagine. 5 years old. No, Mom, leave me here. It's a violation across the border. Give me a break. What do they think is going on? And I also want to make sure these Dreamers are eligible for student aid so they can contribute more to the economy. Pell Grants, community college. I want to end. End the rage and make sure no one's afraid to go to their job or see a doctor or go to their school or worship wherever they decide to worship. I really mean it. We are bigger and stronger than this. And think about this. I didn't think I'd ever see this, but I promise you, I'll protect the men and women who risk their lives in military service. I'll preserve family unification as the foundation of the immigration system because immigration is all about families. That's how we all got here, with notable exceptions. And finally, I'll address the root causes of migration by assisting Central American companies to achieve peace, stability, and the rule of law. People come not because they want to leave what they're used to, because there's no opportunity. They're being abused. They're not safe. They're in a situation where their government's corrupt. Folks, here's the deal. And I'll end that Muslim ban, by the way. Guaranteed. So look, we're going to invest $4 billion over the next 4 years to help those economies that are in deep trouble and not detaining thousands of asylum seekers. Folks, in overcrowded detention centers. My God. I wonder how my Irish great-great-grandparents would have gotten here when my great-great-grandfather got on a coffin ship in the Irish Sea, having to leave his family behind and wondering if he'd ever make it. These are people who've come. You have come here. You're people that are resilient. You're people who are optimistic. You're people who know how to get up and fight back. Look, our approach to the issues like immigration has to reflect our values, as well as our laws and our Constitution. When I talk about the soul of the nation, I'm talking about restoring the backbone of the country. Wall Street didn't build this country. Middle-class workers built this country. People given half a chance built this country. And I'm determined to give the middle class a shot again, a real shot. This time, we build the middle class to bring everybody along. Everybody. Folks, the middle class is getting clobbered. And when they do, the poor have no way up. And guess what? All of it goes to the top. Look, that's the central promise of America, that anyone can succeed regardless who they are, where they came from, where they started off in life. Just give it a shot. My dad used to have an expression. He said, Joey, I don't expect the government to give anything except a chance, just a chance. If we ever lose that notion, we lose the soul of America. And I promise you, it's not going to happen on my watch. When I talk about the soul of the nation, I'm talking about our values, what America stands for: freedom, decency, honesty, democracy, decency, human rights. We stand with our allies and we stand up against dictators. We keep our word. Because we'll be less safe in the world. And the world will be less safe if we don't once again step up and lead the world. Because if we don't, a vacuum's created and the bad guys fill it. You know, I learned something in the last 2 months. Vladimir Putin doesn't want me to be president. Because he knows I know him and I looked him in the eye. I've met with him many times. I believe that every fiber of my being will beat Donald Trump because of who he's embraced. I just read 2 weeks ago that the guys out in the street and Trump, they love sending love letters to Kim Jong-un, a thug. Well, the official news agency of North Korea announced, I guess it was about 10 days ago, Joe Biden is a rabid dog and should be beaten to death with a stick. I'm very proud of that. And guess what? Then Trump sent him a love letter. And by the way, have you ever seen a time when a sitting president, about 9 months before a primary even begins, the first caucus, is spending $10 to $15 million on air telling lies about me because he wants to pick who the nominee is? I wonder why he doesn't want me to be the nominee. Folks, with your help, I'll beat him and beat him like a drum. Look. But when we do, when Trump is defeated, we will, in fact, the next president, whoever he or she is, will inherit a divided nation and a world in disarray. There'll be no time for on-the-job training. You have to be able to stand on January the 21st after inauguration, 2021, and command the world stage. Where our allies know you know them and you'll be with them, and our enemies know you know them as well. When the president speaks, the world will know once again that we keep our word, we honor our commitments, and our adversaries will know we will once again lead the free world in democracy and stand with them. And lastly, folks, we're going to need a president who can unify the nation at home. Believe it or not, and they're all good candidates I'm running with, a couple of the candidates out there attacking me and the very idea that I say we can unite the country. They seem to think America's so divided, it can never be united again. Well, let's get something straight. That's not what I think. And that's not what the country thinks either. Last time I checked, this was called the United States of America. And anyone who starts off saying we can't bring America together is just throwing in the towel. They're saying everything Donald Trump has been saying, the divider in chief. They're saying he's already won, but they're wrong. I'm running to unite this country. The next president has to bring America together again. And I'm going to say something that, in fact, is the only way to do that is to deal with the progressive, durable change we're trying to make happen, from health care to climate change to education, across the board, in immigration. Look, it's important to have plans. And I'm proud of my immigration plan, my health care plan, my climate plan, my education plan, how to strengthen unions, rural America, etc. I'm proud of it. But the fight ahead of us is not about just to have plans. It's about repairing the soul. Who's it going to be to take on and get these things passed? We need someone with proven ability to bring people together and do the hard work of getting legislation passed. I've done that before. Finding Republican votes for the Recovery Act, Obamacare, helping keep us from falling into the Great Depression. I'm the only guy that's taken on and beaten the NRA twice. Passed the Brady Bill requiring background checks and assault weapons. I beat the NRA, and together, we will beat them again. Folks, more than anything, and this is not hyperbole, I mean this from the bottom of my heart. More than anything, I believe in the promise of this nation. I'm more optimistic today than I was elected when I was a 29-year-old kid in the United States Senate. I mean this sincerely. We just have to remember who we are. This is the United States of America. There's nothing we cannot do if we do it together. Folks, we have the greatest research universities in all the world, more than all the rest of the world combined. Our workers are 3 times as productive as workers in Asia. We are in a position where the wealthiest nation on earth will remain that if we invest in our people. But give me the honor of being the nominee for this party. I promise you. There's nothing we cannot do. Nothing we cannot do. Folks, we're in a situation where we got to remember, as I said, who we are. This is the United States of America. So get up and let's take it back now.
stand up and face the world. And if you do that, keep on to me.